स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू डॉक्टर दीपा डाकेज नीट बायोलॉजी। एंड इन टुडे सेशन वी डिस्कस अबाउट द एंडो मेम्ब्रेन सिस्टम। एज आई टोल्ड इन लास्ट सेशन दैट सेल वॉल आई स्किप हियर बिकॉज अकॉर्डिंग टू एनसीईआरटी आफ्टर प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन और सेल मेम्ब्रेन, सेल वॉल टॉपिक इज देयर एंड देन एंडो मेम्ब्रेन सिस्टम, बट फॉर ड्यू टू सम कॉन्सेप्चुअल पर्पस I skip the cell wall here. First we complete all cell organelles and then we come towards the cell wall. So when we begins with cell organelles, so here you remember different kinds of cell organelles are present in cell. Some of the cell organelles are bounded by two membranes, some cell organelles bounded by a single membrane, whereas the ribosome is the one and only cell organelle which is devoid of membrane, or you can say it is present without membrane. Secondly, some of the cell organelle like endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi body, vacuoles, lysosome are interconnected with each other. That's why today we study about endomembrane system and the cell organelles which are comes under the endomembrane system. So here what do we understand by endomembrane system? So first, in simple terms, you remember endomembrane system when we study. So here you remember cell organelles associate with each other or connected with each other or comes under endomembrane system. Mostly these organelles are present around nucleus in endoplasm, part of cytoplasm. So cytoplasm, you know, it is divided into exoplasm and endoplasm. Peripheral region of cytoplasm is called exoplasm, and the part of cytoplasm towards the nucleus is called as endoplasm. And in that endoplasmic region, these cell organelles are predominantly present. That's why we comes these cell organelles are the part of endomembrane system. Now the most important part is that what cell organelles are included under the endomembrane system. So here you remember I use the short form here, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi body, lysosome and vacuoles, you remember, are the four cell organelles which are included under endomembrane system. Why? Because all they are interconnected with each other functionally. If we come towards mitochondria, chloroplast and some another cell organelles in animal cell, we study about centrosome, ribosomes, number of another cell organelle, but these cell organelle, you remember, not interconnected with each other. That's why the mitochondria, chloroplast, centrosome are not included under endomembrane system. So this much you remember for the introduction for part for the endomembrane system. And now we directly begins with our session, that what is endoplasmic reticulum and how does the endoplasmic reticulum vary in when it present as a smooth endoplasmic reticulum or rough endoplasmic reticulum. So here first we study about cell organelle endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, now what does the reticulum means in biology terms are important. As I told you in previous sessions, reticulum means, you remember, when a network like structure is present, that fine network is called as reticulum. endoplasmic because it is developed from the endoplasmic part of the cytoplasm or it is present in the endoplasmic region. That's why it is called as endoplasmic reticulum. First, you remember the discovery. It was discovered by Porter. Secondly, from which part of the cell endoplasmic reticulum is developed? So this you remember, the endoplasmic reticulum, you remember it is developed from external membrane or outer membrane of nucleus. So developed from outer nuclear membrane, and secondly it continuously present up to the plasma membrane. So first you remember it developed from outer nuclear membrane. Second, you remember the endoplasmic reticulum is present in between nuclear membrane and plasma membrane, one of the most important part, that it is called as endoskeleton of the cell. Because endoplasmic reticulum provide a rigidity to the cell cytoplasm, or specific shape and hardness of the cell is maintained because of the presence of the endoplasmic reticulum. Now, why it provide rigidity? Because it present in between the nuclear membrane and plasma membrane. So this you remember very well. Now when we study about the endoplasmic reticulum, so endoplasmic reticulum, you remember, mainly it is consist of three components. So here you will study the components of the endoplasmic reticulum. When we begins with components, so here you remember what are the three major components. So three major components, you remember, the first is tubule, second is cisternae, and the third, you remember, the third component of the endoplasmic reticulum is called as vesicles. So first we see how the tubule and cisternae are the different structure, or they differ from each other. And when we study the presence of ribosome in endoplasmic reticulum, so on which of the component ribosomes are mainly located, so this part we study. So here first you see, this is the cell. We draw cell here. Inside the cell, nucleus is present, and this nucleus, you remember, show the outer membrane and inner membrane. The outer membrane of nucleus is continue, and this outer membrane is continue in the form of tubules and vesicles, and these tubules and vesicles are continue up to the plasma membrane or cell membrane. So this part you remember. And now is it clear to all that ki why it is called the endoskeleton? One term you study, cytoskeleton. Cytoskeleton means the proteinaceous fibers of the cell is called come in contact with each other and form one framework element, that is called cytoskeleton. Endoskeleton means, as in our body, bones provide a rigidity and internal protection. In the same way, this endoplasmic reticulum provide a rigidity to the cell because it present in between the nuclear membrane and plasma membrane. First thing you remember. Secondly, when you study the structure, so here you remember two types. With this diagram only you remember, and the diagram which is provided for endoplasmic reticulum in NCRT, you remember that diagram very well along with the labeling. Because I think in 2013, one time you confirm yourself also, in 2013 the diagram is asked for the position of RER and SER in NEET exam. So for that purpose also you go very carefully in each and every diagram of the NCRT. So yahan pe dekhiye, this is the diagram, and when we study the rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum, so what are these, that we study later. But rough endoplasmic reticulum, you always remember, RER is always present towards the nuclear membrane, and HCR is present towards the plasma membrane. This part you remember very well. Okay, now when we come towards the structures, so here you see tubules and here we study about cisternae. Clear? Tubules, you remember, they are open at one end, and secondly tubule ka meaning clear hai, the filamentous tubular structure. But tubules in case of endoplasmic reticulum are branched or they may be unbranched, these type of structures. And secondly tubules, you remember, predominantly tubules when present. So tubules, you remember, tubules predominantly present in between cisternae. So cisternae are interconnected with the tubules, you can say, and tubules are open ended or they are open at a one end and branched or unbranched structure. Secondly, when you tubule study, so tubule, you remember, on tubule ribosomes are completely absent. Ribosome never be present on tubules. When we come towards cisternae, you remember, the diameter of the cisternae is nearly uniform throughout the length. Cisternae are closed at both the ends, but all the cisternae are parallelly arranged. So whenever cisternae are present, they are closed at both the end, first thing. Second, you remember, parallel arrangement, diameter is nearly uniform. And when we study the presence of ribosome, so one of the most important point, the ribosomes are present on the external surface of cisternae. So whenever a rough endoplasmic reticulum aap study karenge, so in rough endoplasmic reticulum predominantly, you remember, the cisternae are present as a component. So this part you remember. So here you remember ribosome present. Now when we say ribosome is present on cisternae, so one question is raised, what type of ribosome? Because we study there are two types of ribosome, 70S and 80S. And in endoplasmic reticulum, when ribosome is present, so one thing you conceptually clear, that the ribosomes whatever present, these all are 80S type ribosomes are present. Why? Because endoplasmic reticulum is a key feature of eukaryotic cell, and in eukaryote the 80S ribosome is only present. So this part you remember. Secondly, when this 80S ribosome, you remember, when this ribosome is present on the external surface of cisternae, so the ribosome is attached with its 60S subunit, because ribosomes are made up of two subunits. In 80S, larger subunit is called 60S and the smaller subunit is called as 40S. Don't be go towards the mathematical calculation. These are the two densities of different subunits of the ribosome. So the 40S is a smaller subunit, 60S is a larger subunit. So 60S subunit bind with the cisternae, and when it binds, so here one question is asked, that how the ribosome bind with the cisternae. So here you remember, the 60S subunit of ribosome bind to external surface of cisternae with the help of riboforin protein. So this part you remember again for your objective purpose or for the NEET exam. So this you remember. Now we come towards the third component. Third component aapne yahan pe study kiya hai, vesicles. Now vesicle, how does the vesicles are developed? So vesicle, you remember, vesicles develop from the cisternae as well as from the tubule when the cisternae and vesicles participate in the secretion of particular molecules. At that time the cisternae gets cut off, and then the cisternae as well as tubule, you remember, the cisternae as well as tubule both will result in the formation of small rounded bodies. These small rounded bodies you remember called as vesicle. So this part you clear very well, that how does the vesicle? Vesicles are formed by tubule as well as formed by the cisternae. And these vesicle, why the vesicles are present or what is the function of vesicle? So vesicle, you remember, vesicle, when the tubules responsible for vesicle production, so the vesicles of tubule contain the lipid and the vesicles of cisternae are responsible for the storage of protein. So that we will study when we study about the two types of endoplasmic reticulum. So first you clear about these three components of the endoplasmic reticulum, because the students are greatly confused in between the tubules and cisternae, and even they never recognize that where the ribosomes are present, and this part is conceptually, this part is important for your NEET exam. Now we come towards the types of endoplasmic reticulum. Now it is clear to all, the types of endoplasmic reticulum predominantly according to the presence or absence of ribosome. So here when we study about the type of endoplasmic reticulum, so two types of endoplasmic reticulum we study. The first endoplasmic reticulum, you remember, is called as smooth walled endoplasmic reticulum or smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and in short it is called as SER, whereas the second one, where the ribosomes are present, called rough walled endoplasmic reticulum or RER. Okay, now we study how these endoplasmic reticulum are differ from each other. When we study SER, so you simply remember, in SER ribosomes are completely absent, whereas in rough endoplasmic reticulum, why the surface is rough? Because the ribosomes are present on the external surface. If you put the sand particles on any of the smooth surface, automatically the surface become rough. Similarly, you remember, if the ribosomes are present on the surface of endoplasmic reticulum, you can say, so that endoplasmic reticulum is rough endoplasmic reticulum. So here you remember ribosomes. Now what type? So ATS, you remember, are present. Now we come towards the second difference, that is a component. What are the components of the endoplasmic smooth endoplasmic reticulum? So here you remember, the tubules and vesicles are the component of smooth endoplasmic reticulum. This part you remember. But when we come towards the rough endoplasmic reticulum, so here you remember, the cisternae and vesicles, are the main components. Tubule you can say absent in RER, and cisternae is absent in SER. Function wise they are also differ. Here the main function is lipid synthesis. You remember, the smooth endoplasmic reticulum responsible for lipid synthesis, and rough endoplasmic reticulum is responsible for protein synthesis. So this part you remember. Now where they are present or in what kind of tissues we observe the presence of these both endoplasmic reticulum. So here you remember, when you go towards the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, so smooth endoplasmic reticulum, you remember, they are present in liver and muscles cell. This part you remember very well, muscle cell, because when you go towards the contraction of muscles, muscle contraction phenomena, when we study in animal physiology section, locomotion and movement ke chapter mein, in that part one term is provided, sarcoplasmic reticulum. So that also you remember, the smooth endoplasmic reticulum of the muscle cell is predominantly called as sarcoplasmic reticulum. So mainly you remember, for SER it is present in liver and muscle cell, whereas RER you remember present in dividing cells, whenever the cell undergoes in division, so excessively dividing cells, you remember, show the presence of rough endoplasmic reticulum. This part, these are the major differences between the SER and RER. As well as when we say the lipid synthesis, so steroids, you remember, steroidal hormones, steroid are the lipid molecule or the molecule of fatty acid. So in NCERT, one statement provided for the smooth endoplasmic reticulum for its function. That statement is important, so you underline that statement, and the statement states that the SER are associated with the steroid synthesis. Steroid, why steroid synthesis? Because steroids are originally lipid molecules, or they are the molecules of fatty acids. So this part you remember for the types of endoplasmic reticulum and their function. Now another important part remember here for the muscles. So in muscles you remember one question is there for sarcoplasmic reticulum. So sarcoplasmic reticulum means you remember sarcoplasmic reticulum is a reticulum or endoplasmic reticulum which is present in muscles. The cytoplasm of muscle is called as sarcoplasm. That's why the endoplasmic reticulum is called as sarcoplasmic reticulum. This sarcoplasmic reticulum, you remember, this sarcoplasmic reticulum is a type of smooth endoplasmic reticulum. And identifying feature of the sarcoplasmic reticulum, you remember, the tubules are transverse tubule. So one thing you remember, the transverse tubule are present in sarcoplasmic reticulum. So this much you remember for the endoplasmic reticulum. That first you remember who discovered, that Porter. After that you remember the endoplasmic reticulum present in between the nuclear membrane and plasma membrane. Because of that it provides the rigidity. Three components are there. Tubules are unbranched without ribosome. They may be branched and open at one end, and generally tubules present in between the cisternae. Cisternae are parallelly arranged. Secondly, the cisternae are nearly similar in diameter. Throughout the length they are similar in diameter. And vesicles, vesicles are developed from the, kahan se develop ho rahe? They develop from tubule as well as from the cisternae. One question is there, which is the common element of the SER and RER. Common element here, you remember, the common element is vesicle, because vesicle is present in both smooth endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulum. So this much you remember for the endoplasmic reticulum. With this I also sum up my session, and in next session we will discuss about the Golgi body. Already कहा है आपको कि small small topics हम लोग study करेंगे, because each and every child is not capable to study all the things at a time. तो ये मेरी duty होती है कि मैं सभी students को थोड़ा ध्यान में रख के अपने sessions prepare करती हूँ. Okay, the students who are brilliant, they can go at a time, sit at a time and listen the sessions, 2-3 sessions at a same time. And next session we study about Golgi body as well as lysosome, क्योंकि थोड़ी थोड़ी speed भी आप सभी को improve करनी है. So two topics we study from the next session. Okay, and the students who are new for the session, kindly they go through the previous topics and subscribe my channel. बोलना पड़ता है मुझे, so kindly subscribe my channel and share my videos, like my videos. And if you feel any doubt or any queries, so again I am saying, please or kindly discuss those doubts and queries, because आपको exam देना है. मेरे अपनी तरफ से nearly कुछ doubts तो clear ही है, क्योंकि मैं कभी भी नहीं कहती हूँ कि I am 100%, no one is 100%, है ना. Something should be lacking is always there. तो आप queries को clear करते जाइए, NCERT को time to time read करते जाइए. Because biology के लिए one and only though you go through the refresher books, but if you want to crack NEET, that means you only believe in biology. ठीक है, बायोलॉजी एनसीईआरटी बुक्स ऑफ द बायोलॉजी. ओके, सो बाय दैट टाइम स्टे मोटिवेटेड, स्टे ब्लेस एंड स्टे कनेक्टेड विद डॉक्टर दीपा डाके, नीड बायोलॉजी.